Welcome to the one video that will take you from Excel charts newbie to Excel charts pro. And for this, we'll be going over 5 charts and ranking them in terms of difficulty from 1 star all the way to 5 stars. So let's get into it. First up, in level 1, we've got a doughnut chart. And this can make sense to track something like a customer satisfaction score out of 100. So let's look into the Excel file, which you can download in the description below. So over here, you can see that we already have 2 of these doughnut charts made. One for Europe, which as you can see, they're dynamic. So if the satisfaction score drops to 50%, then that's gonna change accordingly over here. Press Ctrl Z to go back. Let's do the same thing with Asia over here. Let's say that their satisfaction score is 75%. So if that's the case, the unsatisfied is the remainder. So we'll go 100% equals 100% minus the satisfied proportion. That's gonna be that. So from here, to go ahead and do the doughnut chart, we're just gonna select it first, Ctrl Shift down. Control Shift right, we're gonna go under insert. From here, you're gonna go under the pie chart that you can see. And then just below that, towards the bottom, you're gonna find the doughnut chart that we're interested in. Let's go ahead and put it over here to the side. Let me resize it a bit. And so first things we gotta do here is we're gonna have to make it a bit thicker. So we'll go ahead and select it, go to right click. We're gonna go format data series. And over here, the doughnut hole size is what we want to decrease. So we'll just make it more or less kind of like that. Then for the colors, this orange part is gonna be the remainder for us. So let's say we put it in a lightish color. So go under format, under shape fill, we're gonna put this light orange here. And then for this other area, go ahead and select it. We're gonna put the darker orange color like this one over here. We can delete that legend. So click on it and press delete there. And then for this text box that actually updates automatically, it's a bit more complex. So let's go about that. Firstly, let me close this area, we'll select the chart, and then from there you want to go under insert. Here we're going to insert a text box. So to do that, just go under text box, and we're just going to put it more or less right in the center, kind of like so. Nice. Now this, we want it to be dynamic, so we want it to link essentially. For this, we're just going to have to go under the data bar. So once we have this area here selected, we're going to go to the formula bar, go to the equal sign. From here, we're gonna select the satisfied area. That's gonna autofill for you there and hit enter. Great, now we just need to format this. So we'll put it in the center, both top and from the sides as well. We'll put it in the center there, say Control B to bolden it. And let's just make it a bit bigger there. So we'll select something like, just keep pressing the A a bit so it looks a bit better. So that seems about right. Then for the color, you simply have to change it from here. Let's say we go for this dark orange over here. And that's the basic idea with the doughnut chart. Obviously now it's all gonna be dynamic. So if I change this to a 60, then that's gonna change accordingly. All right, moving on to level 2. And over here, we're gonna have a comparison between our actual expenses and our budgeted expenses for our company. So let's take a look at that. Over here, as you can see, you have all of the different line items. So the employees, the office space, etc., etc. We can start to see what the difference is gonna be like here. So let's go ahead and select the whole data set. You can just press Ctrl A for that. Then we're gonna go under insert again. And in this case, we're just gonna go to the column chart dropdown here. We're gonna select this very first one, which is the most standard type. Great. Now from here, what we wanna do is essentially have the actuals go inside of the budget area so we can see how far in we are within the budget region. Now to do so, we'll just select that orange side. Go, make sure you select all of them. From there, right click. And here we're gonna go to format data point. So here we want it to be the secondary axis. Go ahead and click on that. And now you can see that one's basically inside of the other. We just gotta make it a bit skinnier so we can actually see it. So on the gap width here, let's say we go for something like a 400, hit enter there. Now you can clearly start to see where it's looking, what it's looking like. So for this one, because these are expenses, let's just put them in red. So we're gonna put them, go under format here. And the shape fill, we're just gonna select a red color like this one over here. And then for the background side, let's go with the shape outline of that same red. So that's gonna be the border area. And for the shape fill, we're gonna go with a lighter reddish color like this one over here. Now you can clearly see that for marketing, this is sort of gone out of line over here. And over here for the office space, it's looking a lot better. One final note here is that the proportions don't seem to be exactly the same on both sides. So that's something we need to correct. So for this area over here, let's go ahead and correct that. Go under these columns here, then we'll go to Axis Options. For the maximum value, we want that to be at 600, so it's accurate to compare with the other one. So we'll go at 600. Now they're in gaps of 100 as we want them here. So it makes a lot more sense. Then we can go ahead and delete that one side just by clicking delete there, and there you go. And thank you to Morning Brew for sponsoring this video. Instead of aimlessly scrolling through social media, you can start your day with knowledge from Morning Brew, a free daily newsletter to get you up to speed on business, finance, and tech in just 5 minutes. While reading traditional news can sometimes feel a bit dry and dense, Morning Brew is witty, relevant, and informative. For example, I recently learned about the labor shortages that are causing airline chaos, and how Amazon is shifting its strategies by slowing down its expansion under its new CEO, Andy Jassy, who's reducing the number of warehouses and brick-and-mortar stores. So if you're interested in learning about all of this and more, go to a link in the description below. It's completely free and it only takes 15 seconds to sign up. Alright, back to the video. Next up, in level 3, we've got the waterfall chart. And this makes the most sense when you have a starting value, something that happened along the way, and an ending value. So for example, it could be with employee headcount. If we look at this example over here, you can see that we've got the 2021 total employee headcount. Then we hired some people, we demoted some, we laid some off, and eventually we reached a 2022 figure. And so if you want to see that whole progress, a waterfall chart makes a lot of sense. Let's go about that by pressing Ctrl Shift down, Ctrl Shift right. We'll go to insert. From here, we're just gonna go to this one over here, double click on that, and then we're gonna go under waterfall, which is that first one. So this is currently what we've got, but it doesn't quite make sense in that the waterfall doesn't quite fall, it just keeps going up for some reason. So this last figure is the one that is probably off. So we'll click on it, just double click it to isolate it, right click, we're gonna set it as total. And so now that's gonna make a lot more sense for us. And over here in orange, we've got the demotions. Let's change these to something like a red color. So we're just gonna isolate the decrease sign there just by clicking on it again. For the format, we don't want an outline, so no border basically, no outline. And for the shape fill, let's go with a red color. And so for the increase, we should have them in this blue color. Now for this total one, for the two totals, let's say we put them in a darker blue, so they seem a bit separate. Let's go with this one and this total figure as well. So we'll just click inside the legend for it, click on the shape fill, and we'll change it to a dark blue. So as you can see here, even though we hired a good number of people, 50 in this case, it seems like quite a few left the company, which probably isn't too good a sign. You can get rid of the grid lines as well, just by clicking on them and pressing delete. Coming in at level 4, we've got the forecast chart. And this obviously makes the most sense when you want to forecast the trend into the future. So looking at the Excel file that we've got down over here under the forecast tab, you can see that we've got Netflix, which is the ticker symbol is this one over here. So Netflix shares with their date and their closing price. Let's say that this is the share price that we invested in about a year ago, and this is how it's been progressing for us. And we want to determine whether it's worth continuing to own this share or whether we should sell it. If you go to control down arrow, you'll see that we own this share pretty much up till today. And so we've got the share prices for every Monday over here. Now to forecast it into the future, we're just going to go under the data tab. Then you're going to go to forecast sheet, which is this tab over here. Click on that. Now you can start to see the pop-up of Excel's forecast of what it's going to do based on the previous data. So this whole year's worth of data from the past. And so here you can see when the forecast is ending. In this case, it's around September. And this is the estimate of what it's going to do. You can go under options to see more of the different variables that you can tweak from here. So for example, in this case, you can change the confidence level and other things like that that are related to statistics. This case, we'll just hit create for now. So as you can see, Excel created a new sheet for us. And what this is saying, these curved lines are saying, is that within 95% of the time, the share price should fall within this range. So it's saying that it's probably not going to be any higher than around 300, which isn't too great a sign if you want to keep investing in it. Now you can see that Excel also made this table. This is basically how it calculated all the data. As you can see over here, these are the calculations that it's made going into the future. You can look into them if you're interested. On a serious note though, I don't recommend using Excel to try and forecast whether you should buy or sell a share. This is just an example, so don't use it in real life. Lastly, in level 5, we've got a column chart with percentage changes. And I'll be very impressed if you already knew how to do this one. So let's go to control page down, all the way to the bottom here. And this is the data set that we'll be working with. So over here, we've got the monthly breakdown of the revenue and how that compares versus the next month. If you click inside the next month, it's basically the following month there, so you can see the comparison. And I've gone ahead and made some things like the variance percentage, press the F2 key to look inside that, which is basically the percentage change from one to the other, the variance, which is just one minus the other. And over here, I've got a table where it basically says, hey, if the figure's positive, then you gotta put it on this side. And if it's negative, you gotta put it on this other side. As you can see, I put the positive changes as a negative figure based on this figure right over here. And the condition here just says that if the variance over here is greater than, if it's greater than zero, then I want it to put a negative sign in front. Now, the reason I'm doing this, you'll be able to see after in the chart. That's an overview of the data set. So let's get into actual charting. We'll go ahead and select this top area over here. We'll just select these first three columns. Then we'll go under insert. And for now, we're just gonna go with a simple 2D clustered column like this one over here. Let me just drag that down a bit more so we can see it. We'll just put it down over here. We're gonna remove that legend. So go ahead and click on it and hit delete there. We don't really need the title for now, just cause I'm gonna show you how to make the chart more generally. And so for this orangish area, which is basically the next month figures, we wanna make this transparent. So we're gonna go under format. Then for the shape fill, we're gonna go to no fill. Same thing with the outline, we want no outline. Great. Now we're gonna go to chart design. And here's where we're gonna start putting the percentage changes basically. So go to add chart element, go to error bars, then more error bar options. I know this is a bit daunting here. And towards the bottom, you're gonna reach a custom area. Click on that, then under specify value, the positive error value is gonna be this whole range that we set up earlier, It's gonna be this area here. Then the negative one is gonna be this other area over here. Click that again and hit okay there. Now you can start to see that you've got these lines which are gonna give you the range of that difference. Then we'll click inside that transparent data bar. So just click inside it, then go to right click. And actually we already have it up here. Go to format data series. If you don't see it, it's gonna be this button over here. Now for these, the series gap, we're just gonna put at 0%. And same thing goes for the gap width. We're gonna put it at 0%. And now we wanna add a few labels which are gonna be the percentage change for us. So right click, go to add data labels. Now for now you can see that we just get the standard numbers, which is not quite what we want. So we'll click on them, then go to this column area, go to that, then we're gonna go value from cells, which allows us to select specific values within the range. So go to value from cells, and the select data label range is what's gonna pop up for us. In our case, we're interested in the percentage changes, which are these figures here. Hit okay there. And we don't want the values anymore because that's kind of too much info. We'll deselect that values area. And now that's looking more like it. So let's go ahead and change these by pressing Ctrl B to bolden them first. And let's also go to home. And for the text here, let's say we go for a red color. Let me go inside there and select, actually let's put a green for the positives. And then for the negatives, which is one's this one over here, and the other one's this one, which you can see they're not very well placed. We'll work on that in a bit. We'll just put them as red first. And then I'm just gonna put them to the inside end. That's gonna be on the bottom here. Same thing with this one. We're just gonna make it red and then put it under the inside end. Let me scroll down so we can see it a bit better there. Let's stretch the graph out a bit like so. And let's change the colors of these columns to something like a darker blue. So go to format, shape fill, let's go with a dark blue. Let's remove the grid lines as they're a bit distracting. And now that's looking a lot more like it. And that's how you go about creating a column chart with percentage changes. Let me know down in the comments below, out of the 5 charts, how many you knew. Check out this video over here for Excel formulas, or this other link over here to learn more about our courses. Hit that like and the subscribe button if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.